So I have 3 days, 11 hours, and 55 minutes to conquer Africa and also edit up the footage of me conquering Africa. Right now, it's not looking too promising as Africa is freaking huge and we're down here at Crewe. We currently own three counties down here, East Crewe, Debre, and Bubo. And they make up the High Chiefdom of Crewe. We made a duchy in the last episode, which did cost us 125 gold, but it gave us a bunch of prestige. And more importantly, we can now start recruiting vassals. We have no need for any yet as we are not over our domain limit, but we're about to be because we're going to start going on a rampage here. Our immediate goal is to capture territory that belongs to another duchy, like over here at Adai Crewe. There's three territories that make it up, and I believe they all belong to different people, so we can attack all three of them. Not at once, we're going to attack them individually to just make this go super quick. And actually, the first guy we want to attack at Adi is already attacking someone else, so this is going to be super easy for us. We're probably not going to take many casualties as he's already at war. We dumped all of our troops on the field. We have 769, they only have 460, and this guy's actually not moving. I believe he was attacking these guys over here, and ooh, we got a diplomacy perk available. In the last episode, we picked up our first diplomacy perk, Befriend. Next, we're going to head down here to Confidants. Each friend adds minus 5% stress gain, and we're going to be making a lot of friends really soon here. We are currently doing a scheme to befriend someone. Down that perk tree, there's a few pretty powerful bonuses for having a lot of friends, and yeah, we captured their holding. We captured a valuable hostage as well, and we can ransom this guy for 50 gold, and okay, we are now the culture head of the Crewe culture already. That was quick. We only need to capture four territories for that, and I guess we own the most territory inside the culture of Crewe, which, like, it's not that big. There's a lot of cultures in Africa. Because we're the culture head, we can now choose a cultural fascination, and we're going to choose Onager, which are siege weapons, and we're going to discover them in 53 years, which our leader is going to be dead by then. Or I guess he'll be really old, but yeah, we want siege weapons because it's going to allow us to siege much quicker. And yeah, even after ransoming their leader, we still can end the war because we own their only county, and they have no more territory left, so yeah. War's over. Immediately after winning that war, we're gonna do another one, and we're gonna attack this guy down here at Dabu. It's another just single county, and it's actually really easy to just wipe these guys out one by one. So we're gonna continue doing that, and this guy did have a few more troops. He has 300 bush hunters. I think the last guy only had 200, but like now we have 1,076 troops. Ooh, our kid actually has the trait rowdy now, and this actually kind of matters, or will matter pretty soon. We should also educate the kid. I kind of forgot to do that. We're gonna have our shaman educate him. He's got our highest learning, and I believe that's all that matters when you're educating a kid. But yeah, more on the rowdy trait a bit later when our kid becomes 6 years old. But yeah, we're now going to attack this guy. We do have 1,076 troops, and we're actually over our domain limit now, which isn't going to give us any penalties yet because we just took this domain. But after a while, we'll start getting penalties, so we're going to want to make a vassal. Now, one of the things I learned about vassals is it is good to have vassals that have good opinion of you, but you also want them to be fairly young. Like this guy, Guardia, is actually a pretty good age. He's also greedy, which increases monthly income. He's got an okay amount of martial, 10, and he's got 5 stewardship. Stewardship and martial are the only things I think that matter when choosing a vassal, and like their opinion of you also matters. This guy down here actually wouldn't be bad. Nimini, he doesn't have that great of opinion of us, but this dude has 17 in martial and like he's greedy. Okay, yeah, he's definitely our first vassal. We picked this guy up as a prisoner at the end of the last episode, and this guy really wants to be on the council, which is perfect because he has more martial skill than our current marshal, Pain Wayne. And even though Pain Wayne has a really cool name, we're gonna have to replace him, unfortunately. And Pain Wayne's not gonna like this too much, although he has 100 opinion of us, so losing that 20 opinion won't matter too much, and this guy really likes us now. We're 87 relation with Nana Nimini, and we can give this guy over one more county, which we're about to do. We're gonna just absolutely destroy this guy. We outnumber him 2-1, and we only have to take one of his counties and the war is over. So we're just gonna fast forward here. He started sieging one of our counties, but it's not gonna matter, I think. By the way, we were doing a befriend scheme on this guy. There's 100% chance this working because we have really good diplomacy skill, and I guess this guy has really good opinion of us. So yeah, we just picked up another friend. We're also about to pick up this guy's castle. We're at 167, and yeah, he's not gonna beat us here. Hopefully he captured their leader again. That'd be cool. Or like just someone important. We captured his wife, apparently. He will ransom her for 25 gold. Very nice. Scroll is not very good anyway, so yeah, we're gonna do that. We're gonna grant over Dabu, our new holding, to our marshal, and that will unfortunately cap him out at 2 domains because the dude does not have good stewardship. And so now when we take more territory, which we're about to, we're gonna keep expanding east, and this guy actually has 3 territories, and it's actually not worth it to attack this guy just yet. We should focus on taking out single county rulers, like this guy up here, who's actually currently defending against this guy. Okay, maybe we don't attack him, because if we were to take him out, then this guy would be attacking us because he wants this holding. So maybe like this guy up here to the north, he does have a sparring grounds built, Actually, that's really nice. Unfortunately, we have a truce on this guy. Okay, so we're not going to attack Nizzy either. Maybe we expand west, I guess. Like, this guy's being sieged. So this guy, Nanan Arma, is fighting this guy, Nanan Lami. And they're both really weak. They only have one county each. So we could actually attack both of them. One of them's here, and one of them's here at Gribo. I think we'll attack Gribo first, because he's currently occupied sieging these guys. Meanwhile, with the siege, it's going really well. And here comes some raiders, by the way. I don't know where they're going. Or they're fighting this dude, who we're attacking. So that's good. They're not raiding us yet. And we did end up capturing this guy's daughter. Can we ransom her for 49 gold? Holy crap, we're so rich. And we just picked up another county. We did apparently inherit a war. We're defending some guy that was trying to take out Crawley, I'm guessing. This guy over here is the one who was trying to take it. He's got 400 troops, and we're just going to try to run him down. Ooh, our main dude is ill. That's not good. We're going to go for the safe treatment here, as our shaman is not a decent physician. He's got 16 learning, but he is not a skilled physician. So yeah, we're going to just do the safe option. Apparently, our shaman's treatment worked out, and we get reduced disease symptoms. Huge boost to our health for 1 year, and that should counteract ill. But yeah, over to this guy who's got his 400 troops. Oh, this is actually cool. While we're doing the befriend scheme, we can get 25 piety for free, or we can get extra scheme success chance, but we already have 88%, so yeah, let's just take that free 25 piety. We need that to keep declaring wars. We're down to 248, and it costs us 50 per war. But yeah, we're about to run this guy down. Well, maybe not. I did put in our commander that gives us 25% more movement speed, though, so it might be helping us here. And oh, we almost caught him, but not quite. He wants to fight in the mountains over here, and moving there is going to make us take attrition. We will take 100 casualties, so we're not going to move there. We're in fact going to just chill, and we're going to split off our armies here. So 520 units led by Payne Wayne are going to head over here to this castle, and they're going to start sieging it. Well, 600, just chill. Okay, this guy's just giving up, I guess. He ran. And here we go. Our defense scheme worked out. We're now friends with this guy. That was one of the better ones, actually, with that free 25 piety. Let's just pick another guy to befriend. 97% on this guy. Yeah, let's do that. He was way up here at Udalan, I think. Doesn't really matter where they are. They just can't be too far away or you can't interact with them. But yeah, we're just going to have... Okay, I was going to say we're going to have our other army come over here and help these guys siege. But no, these guys are trying to be sneaky. But we see you. We're going to run you down, my friend. It may seem like we're pretty close in strength to these guys, but they only have 200 bush hunters. And in this army, we have 600. We didn't put any levies in this army. They're all our elite units. So yeah, we should tear this guy up. And there we go. Our great leader is not ill anymore. Under the decisions tab, we can also search for a physician yet again. We can do this every 12 months. We're going to start the search. And I actually wouldn't be opposed to paying for a physician. Maybe we'll hold out for one that has really good learning so they can be our shaman and our physician. Because we can do it every year, so we might as well just keep looking for one. And here we go. 40 is the good one. And she's got 2 in the physician trait, but she only has 11 learning. I think we're going to hold out for someone else. And yeah, this girl is not a physician. I don't even know why she showed up. Yeah, meanwhile, over here, this guy is going to fight. Let's actually change our commander to someone that can fight in the jungle better. Or maybe just this guy, Nana Nimene. He's got really good martial skill, 17. He's not as quick as Kanawa, but he has way more martial skill than him. And here we go, we're actually fighting. We have a -5 battle advantage right now. So the enemy's damage is increased by 10%, but it's not really that big of a deal. Looks like we got a good battle roll here. We got a terrible battle roll. We were at like a 1 battle advantage, now we're at -10. So the enemy's damage is increased by 20%, but it's not gonna matter actually. They're all routing already. These guys are trying to retreat. And we're running them down because our bush hunters have good pursuit. We actually killed a lot of them there in the retreat. I guess we won against this little kid and we get 10 prestige. I don't know why we only get 10. I guess that's all he's got. He's got 6. And yeah, with that, we're going to disband all of our armies. Our 500 over here that we're sieging, which they did end up winning that siege, and then that gave us a good amount of war score, and then that battle also gave us a bunch. We're now going to take the word of this kid that was just attacking us, as his army is completely done for, and we're just going to straight up attack him. We're not even going to give him time to retreat. We'll plop all of our armies right by this guy where he's trying to run. And we're probably just gonna do the same strategy here of splitting off our armies. We're gonna have 500 of these guys head over here and take this guy's main capital, and then our 600 are gonna try to chase this guy down. Oh, and this guy's also getting raided too, to make matters worse for himself, by 800 troops. That's a bit scary. Sorry that's gotta happen to you, dude. And crap, actually, this is not good. Our army with just our levies getting caught over here, but it looks like we're winning pretty heavily. Yeah, so that plan of splitting up our armies was not good, but it didn't matter. We stomp that guy out. And we did end up getting a new diplomacy perk while that was all going on. We can pick up Flatterer now, which increases our befriend scheme power by 30%. That's huge. There's a lot more people our befriend scheme is now going to work on, so that's awesome. And yeah, the dude only has 100 troops, so we're probably just going to have both of our armies siege this castle, and the guy really can't do anything about it. And yeah, after taking this capital, that brought our war score up to 71%. We're now going to have to siege his other holding. And what is this guy doing over here with his 100 troops? That's what I thought. He's running for the hills. I sent 600 bush hunters over there almost to try to take him out, but he's not gonna get caught. He's gonna just run. And the war is over if we want it to be. I would like to actually run this guy down first, though, and maybe capture his heir, or his leader, rather. Wait, did he just lose a battle or something? Why is he down to 4 troops? He's 4 troops. I don't know what just happened there. So after taking Wenyan and Gribo, we're now 2 above our domain limit, so we have to make another vassal. I was looking over potential vassal candidates when I noticed this guy Wella, who's got a good amount of stewardship, but he's also a giant. Apparently this guy is the steward of our vassal, but we could, I guess, steal him away. And this guy's actually really solid. He's only 20 years old. He's got 16 stewardship, 9 marshal, and we're going to be able to give him over quite a few territories with that 16 stewardship. We're going to start by giving him over Wenyan and Gribo only, but we're going to definitely end up giving him more. Making this guy our vassal actually gave him a boost of stewardship. He's at 17 now, and we're gonna make him our steward. The two territories we just captured, Wenyan and Gribo, both make up a duchy. They make up the Duchy of Wenyan, and so we can now create another duchy title for 125 gold, and this is required for making a kingdom. As if we do want to become a king and make the kingdom of a Daikru, we need 2 duchy titles. There is, however, a way to get around this, and we can save that 125 gold if we take someone else's duchy. And there is a duchy over here at Kano, and it just so happens we have almost a perfect amount of prestige to subjugate this guy, which means we're essentially going to make him our vassal. After sieging his castle for a few months, he's now mounting a retaliation force. This guy has 880 troops, 300 bush hunters, and he's going for, I'm guessing, our capital. Like, he's heading over here to Debri. We're going to try to run him down with all of our bush hunters. And nice, over here we won the siege. We're going to have these guys keep moving on. I hope we can make it over here in time before he sieges this thing. We should be able to. Like, he just started sieging. He's only got 62 siege progress. Oh, he just got a huge bump in siege progress. He's only got 53 days left. This could be really bad if he actually takes it. Oh, phew, he gave up. I think he could have taken it, but our army would have caught him afterwards. And we caught him anyways. We got 907, he's got 864, but we have 7 knights. And 900 of our units are bush hunters, only 300 of his are. So you can imagine that we will be destroying him here. Our champion named one of them, very nice. Our champion Pain Wayne was wounded. Okay, and that's it for this guy. For the most part, like, he's gonna run now back to his territory. Back in his territory, we won the siege, and the war is actually over if we want it to be. This war was kind of a big deal, and for winning it, we get 350 fame, and this guy becomes our vassal now. We can now almost make the kingdom of a Daikru. We just need 19 more gold, and we can make it. Oh, and by the way, I found a trick you can do with the befriend scheme. So you can actually befriend people that are like Herculean, for example. Like, this guy's got 14 prowess. He's going to make for a good knight, minus the fact that he's craven, although this makes it so he's less likely to die in battle, which is good. But yeah, so this guy's going to make for a decent knight, and we could potentially make babies with him if we marry him to like our daughter. He is Chasto, which lowers his fertility, so I don't know if he'd make for a great baby maker. But either way, he was in like this guy's court, and I was able to find him. I'll show you guys how I did that. And we were able to befriend him. Our befriend scheme worked. And now we can just invite this guy to our court, and he will accept. So we just got a really decent knight that's just in our court now. And yeah, there he is. We're now going to force him to be one of our knights. And we just got a really decent guy with 14 prowess, basically for free. And the way I found him is I went down to our new daughter that was born, actually. She unfortunately is sickly. I think we could actually fix that if we did have a good physician. I'm not sure. But she is also beautiful, just like her brother. So that's really cool. We were able to pass down that trait to both the kids we made. But if we go over here to find spouse, we can look up people by their traits. And like, this guy actually is giant and he's quick. And this guy's 14 prowess. He actually wouldn't make for a bad knight. See if we can befriend him. There's a 100% chance of befriending this guy. So yeah, let's do that. But yeah, so meanwhile, we're expanding our territory and we're getting raided. That's annoying. This guy's raiding our capital, and this is gonna hurt our taxes in a second once he's successful. Or he just stole 75 prestige from us. Or actually, the second option is not bad. We can grow closer to forming a rivalry with Nana Owo. Yeah, let's do that instead. And yeah, we just lost half our taxes from debris. So we're now getting 0 gold per month. That's slightly annoying. In order to gain some gold back, we're just doing a little war over here, and we're taking over this guy's only holding of Bassa. This guy ended up running, and he only has 529 troops, so we split up our armies. One is sieging his castle and one's running him down. And here we go, we caught him. Let's see what happens. We're fighting in his advantage, actually, and Pain Wayne was wounded. That's unfortunate. He's got a huge advantage. His damage is increased by 50%, but he does only have 200 bush hunters, whereas our army is made up of mostly bush hunters. We're actually losing a lot here, by the way. We maimed a few of them. Very nice. And we're running them down. And okay, we actually didn't lose any bush hunters there. I guess they just retreated, because we're back up to 900 out of 900. But yeah, we actually didn't need to do that battle. Like, we got 100% war score just from capturing his only territory. I just thought we might end up capturing their main leader guy. After winning that siege, we got 15 gold. And we're almost there where you need 3 more gold. I don't think we're actually going to get any from attacking this guy's territory over here, because his territory was recently looted, so there is no loot here. The dude does have 89 gold though, and so if we do capture their leader, we could end up ransoming him for a bunch of gold and Nice, he's actually about to get caught really badly here. Here we go. We got a negative 18 battle advantage. So their damage is increased, but we do counter a bunch of his units. He's got 200 Guinean Uplanders that are dealing 10% of their normal damage. And their Light Footmen are also only dealing 10% because we counter them super hard with, again, we have around 900 units and they're all Bush Hunters. Oh, and our Marshal actually found this dude who's got 12 prowess. Very nice. And wow, 17 Marshal on this guy. And 10 Stewardship. This guy would make for a good vassal. He's only 30 years old too. So good job to our Marshal for finding this guy. Again, he found him because he's doing the trained commanders thing. But yeah, we won that battle and we ended up capturing this guy who's got 10 prowess. Very nice. We cannot ransom him, so we'll just recruit him to our court. And this guy actually got away and he's now going to probably make it to our levy army that was sieging. Or I guess he's going to run. I'd like to chase him down. And he actually is going to fight. Yeah, he's just going to stand and fight over here. Or, okay, he tried to run at the very last moment, but it was not quick enough. We outnumber him 2-1. Our units are just so much better, though. And, like, even though we have a negative 27 battle advantage, it doesn't even matter. And we beat him again. Unfortunately, again, we did not capture anybody. Or we did capture someone in the siege, though. This kid who we can ransom for 10 gold. That's how much your son's worth to you. Come on, man. Whatever, we'll take the 10 gold. That's all we need to make the kingdom anyways. And yeah, with that, we're at 256 gold. That's going to be enough to create the Kingdom of the Die Crew. So we're going to create that title. And we are now the rank of Mighty Omenheen. At age 27, that's pretty good. We started at age 17, wasn't it? Since we're now higher ranked, we can create another men-at-arms regiment, which you guys already know we're going to make more bush hunters. We're going to add 300 more bush hunters to our army. And because we're now king, we can also now make this vassal happy. So the dude's kind of upset for multiple reasons. He wants a seat on the council, and he's really upset about that, but his stats aren't all that good, so you don't really want to put him on the council. The other thing he's upset about is the fact that he's a title claimant, and he has a claim on this duchy, the High Chiefdom of Kano, that we stole from him earlier. But since we're king now, we can give that back to him. We couldn't before because we were the same rank as him. So if he had a duchy title, he would have been the same rank as us because we also only owned a duchy title, and he would have become independent. But after giving him this, we have really good relation with him, 85, but he still does desire the chiefdom of Sherbro because that's inside of his duchy. The only issue with doing this is it will put him over his domain limit, so he will get some penalties for that, but he wants it, so we're just going to give it to him. And now he's 100 relation with us. We don't have to put him on the council. We're going to stop expanding west, as if we attack like Sanda over here, it's going to cost us prestige, and that's the same for attacking anywhere in this orange area because the people in the orange have a different faith than us. We're going to keep moving east and conquering territory that belongs to the Acom faith, and this is going to allow us to spend piety for doing it, which, by the way, we just got 100 extra piety for free, I guess. We could spend 75 gold and we can get 0.5 prestige per month for 5 years. That doesn't seem that good, and plus 2 diplomacy. We don't have 75 gold though. There's also a stewardship challenge. 64% chance that we lose 75 prestige. Yeah, no thank you. We also gain stress as well. No thanks. We're just going to take the 100 free piety. That's going to be a huge help. That's 2 more wars we can declare on people. Speaking of which, we're now attacking this little guy. He's only got 1 territory. He's also doing the thing where he's trying to run, and yeah, he's not able to run. Holy crap, I was going on 4 speed there. That battle went quick and very nice. We captured their leader and we can ransom this guy for 50 gold. Oh, and our befriend scheme actually paid off a little bit. We're befriending another guy who's Herculean. This dude's not as good though. He's only got 9 prowess, but there's 100% chance of our befriend scheme working, so we don't need to take this first option, which would increase our scheme success chance. We're going to take the second option. That's going to give us 25 more free piety. So yeah, we're up to 400 now, which is awesome. We need that piety badly. Oh, and we're getting raided, by the way. Who dare raids us? Oh wow, this guy's way over here in the west side of our territory. So we can maybe stop this guy if we get over the siege quick enough. Like, we got 20 days left. Oh, very nice. We captured this guy's son, and whoa, he ransomed for 50 gold. And we also captured his wife and his daughter, I think. So we don't want to end the war just yet. We want him to ransom these guys off first, which means we're not going to be able to stop the raiders. Yeah, they already got away. I was going to say we could re-raise our army over here and stop them, but yeah, there's no chance of that anymore. We ransom his wife. He will for 25 gold. Wow, we're just sucking this guy dry. And then what about his daughter? 10 gold for his daughter. How much gold does he have left? He literally has 11 gold. Says he has 10 gold here, but I guess he has 11. Wow, that worked out perfectly. After wiping out this guy, we got another single county ruler over here who does apparently have 1,200 units. He must have hired a mercenary company or something. Yeah, he hired the Marco Band of Gondo for 143 gold. This is going to be one of our bigger battles we've fought thus far. We do have 1,000 bush hunters though, and they countered his mercenary company they picked up. He's not very smart with that, and he's trying to run, but he's not gonna be able to run. We have a negative 15 battle advantage, which is not ideal. Our damage is lowered by 30%, but his 300 Guinean Uplander mercenaries are dealing 10% of their normal damage. Painwain has slain the enemy commander, sending their army into disarray. I've actually never seen that. So they lost their commander, and I think we were getting a good battle advantage while that was happening. I also noticed one of our commanders got wounded and we need to keep searching for a physician. And wow, this guy Garty is actually a renowned physician. He's got a 3-star physician trait and he's got 16 learning. I did notice though, right before this happened, our shaman picked up the novice physician trait. So he's now a 1-star physician. This guy is super old though. He's 68. I don't know how he's living so long. Maybe he's drinking his own urine or something. Nah, don't do that actually. I'm pretty sure it's really bad for you. We're gonna pick this guy up as our physician for 50 gold because yeah, ours is gonna die soon, I think. That guy's gonna be really good at healing our wounded units. Oh, and this actually might not be good. So this guy apparently had an ally and he's going to attack us and they have 1874 troops. We're gonna be having a difficult time here, I think. Although like I see our 1600 and I forget that most of them are bush hunters. Cause yeah, like this guy only has 166 bush hunters. 229 of them are the useless skirmishers that we just destroy. And this guy's, oh yeah, he's got 400 freaking skirmishers and those are useless. Like they're actually worse than levies when they're fighting us. And actually this guy engaged us early too with his 982 troops. We have a negative 10, negative 7 battle advantage now. Payne Wayne was wounded too. We do have 1241 though against his 965 and Ghibli killed one of them. Very nice. And yeah, we're winning this. This is definitely the hardest battle we've had so far, but yeah, you can see our bush hunters are just so strong. We're fighting in favorable terrain too. And so they're each doing 38 damage with a bit of extra toughness too. And yeah, we won that really hard actually. We have 977 still up. And wow, it looks like having friends actually pays off. We just got 50 gold and we lost 10 stress. And that was thanks to Farbus, this nearby leader of a duchy. But after winning those battles, we were able to continue the siege of that guy's only castle, and that was the war over. To the west over here, we're getting raided by 950 troops, and I think we can actually just make a rally point right here. And actually, no, we can't. We have to move the rally point, I guess, to an area that's green. Move right there, and yeah, we'll just plop down our troops. And we'll start attacking this guy right away, I think, if we can. Or I guess we gotta raise our 1500 troops, and yeah, now we can attack this guy. We're gonna get him before he can raid. Oh, and our kid just got a trait. So pro tip is always have your leader educate your heir, because you can choose what traits they get. Like, he got generous, which is not good for a leader, in my opinion. It does give 3 diplomacy, which is nice, but that negative 10% monthly income kind of sucks. We don't really want him to have that trait, and if we want to, for a bit of stress, we can have him trade that trait in for diligent, which gives 1 to pretty much all stats except for prowess. It does increase stress gain by 20% though, which could be a problem. Or we could have him get the patient trait, which increases his learning. I will say I kind of like diligent here for that +1 to all stats. So yeah, we're gonna go for that one. And in the meantime, we ended up catching these raiders. These guys do have Guinean uplanders yet again. Most of these factions up here do have Guinean uplanders, so it's gonna be really easy once we start to take them out. But yeah, we're just gonna absolutely obliterate this guy. We might get some loot or something. He didn't finish his raid, so I don't really know what we're gonna get for this. Our champion Ghibli killed one of them. It'd be cool if we could capture like their leader or something. And no, we didn't capture any of them. Should we just run them down? Or yeah, they actually want to fight in this mountain over here. And they do have advantages in the mountain, I think. But they're just so hard countered that it doesn't even matter. I actually don't know if the Guinean uplanders do have any advantage here. Oh, and very nice. Being friends paid off again. We lost 10 stress. But yeah, let's see what happens when we beat these raiders yet again. Nothing really. Overall, this was kind of a pointless affair, I guess. I mean, we did just stop our county from getting raided, but that was it. And yeah, he disbanded his raiders. He's done. We're gonna disband our troops. We're now expanding our territory east, and we're just gonna conquer this one county over here, or we're gonna try to. This guy who we're attacking does have 3 counties, and he had no allies originally, but once we attacked him, oh, and this is actually kind of interesting. So I decided to befriend a girl this time, and this girl actually has the physician trait. I didn't even notice that, but our scheme worked out on her. I think it was 100% chance anyways, and we can now invite her to our court. She is beautiful, and I think there's like a scheme we can do to impregnate her with our leader. She did just arrive at our court, and we can like romance her or seduce her. Oh, okay, so with the romance scheme, she can become our soulmate, but there's not 100% guarantee, and I think it's actually kind of a low chance. With the seduction scheme though, if the scheme is successful, she will 100% become our lover. So yeah, we should do that. It's gonna make us gain some stress, but I think it's worth it because she could start pumping out some beautiful babies with us. And what is this guy doing? He's going for debris. And it's not just him, he's actually got some friends coming for debris. I also should probably build some defensive buildings at debris because they literally do the same thing every time. Like they always go for debris, and it would be probably worth to build some palisades over here. But yeah, we will make it here in time, and we got way better units than them, I'm guessing. They have 296 bush hunters plus 198. So around 500 total. We got 1k. We already know how this is gonna end. Before we engage them, let's swap out our commander too for our marshal. That's kind of OP actually. We used our commander that was boosting our movement speed to get to here. here. And now we're going to use a new commander who has way better martial skill. So he's going to help us in combat. And yeah, we caught these guys. We got way more battle advantage. And I was going on really fast speed there. So that battle was going really quickly. Our champion maimed one of them. Okay, that's fine. And the battle's over. They're retreating. And yeah, they got destroyed. I just blackmailed someone and that made us gain stress. Oh no. The thing that sucks about that is there was really no reason to do it. And yeah, we now have stress level 1. So we now have a mental breakdown and we can potentially get reclusive, which is not good. It lowers our diplomacy and stewardship, but it will lower our stress. Hashisha lowers our stewardship and learning, which isn't actually that big of a deal. We don't really need stewardship and learning too much. I think if we go down to 4 stewardship though, our domain limit will go down to 3 maybe, but oh well. We'll just have our leader start smoking that hash to deal with his stress. And yeah, our domain limit went down to 3, which is fine. Like our domains aren't really giving us that much anyways. Like they're a bunch of crappy tribal villages. Although I will say like Buki does have a sparring grounds built in already. The dude we captured that from built that, but then like East Crew over here doesn't have anything built in it. So we can just give that one over. So yeah, we only have 3 holdings now. Bassa over here does have longhouses built in it too. So that gives us more control growth and 0.2 more prestige for our realm and some more levies. But other than that, yeah, we haven't done any upgrading to anything really. Oh, and here we go. We have a battle coming up over here. Our levies that were sieging this guy's castle got attacked by this guy's army that retreated from the battle we just fought him in. Oh, and he got caught by the other guy too. So they had like a coordinated attack on our levies. Hopefully our army can get in here in time though. We're getting obliterated right now because yeah, these troops suck. And there we go. We got our bush hunters in here. They're about to mop the floor with these guys. Hopefully we can capture one of their leaders. That'd be ideal. Our champion was maimed. That's not good. Or if Teppo is any good. There we go. We captured a valuable hostage. The war could be over if we wanted it to. And really, they won't ransom him. It's their son and heir, but he will not ransom the kid. Well, his son's not that good, so we're just going to end the war. We're not going to keep going because, yeah, we'd have to siege this guy's castle. Instead of doing that, we can just attack like this kid up here who's got 1 territory and he's got no allies and he's got 141 troops. We've been just constantly declaring wars on people. Like we're always in war, basically. And we're not losing piety, which is really nice. We're still up to 422. And oh no, I have to choose an option for the seduction scheme. There's a chance that we could get some awkward interactions here and that would lower our scheme success chance by 15. So we got to read something to this girl that she would want to hear. Something pious? Would she want to hear about religion? I mean, she is religious. Or does she want to hear something entertaining? Which, what would that be based on? Maybe diplomacy? And she does have 20 diplomacy. Or does she want to hear something informative? Which that would be based on like learning, I'm guessing. Since she does have the astute intellectual education trait, let's go with informative. Good choice. Hey, there we go. And she rearranged her blouse. Interesting. It was great, wasn't it? And yeah, our scheme should work now. We ended up winning the siege against this kid and we took his brother prisoner, who we will ransom for 10 gold. So we'll do that and we can end this war now. Or wait, we actually captured his sister too. We should ransom her for 6 gold. That's all he's got. After taking Bondaku, we're going to keep expanding east and we're actually going to conquer this guy's duchy. Doing this is going to cost us 250 piety, but we can take 3 counties at once, which would have costed us 150 anyways. And doing this is just going to be much quicker. This guy does have a lot of territory though. This was a person we were fighting earlier though, so their troops not healed up yet. And neither has her allies down here. We just took 1 territory from him. And there we go. Our seduction scheme was successful. Bintu Zara becomes our lover. The second option would just be we just lay with her, but no, we want her to be our lover. And hopefully she's going to start making our babies. And here we go. Our heir picked up another trait, content. This one's actually not bad. It just increases learning by 2, gives more stress loss, which would kind of counteract diligent a bit. That increases the stress gain. We could also teach him a more flexible way of thinking, and that would make him gain fickle, but that one doesn't seem all that good. Or we could teach him this trait, trusting, which increases diplomacy. That's pretty good. It also increases the opinion of vassals and liege, which I think actually that's decent for a leader. It just increases enemy hostile scheme success chance against the leader, which could be bad. I think your leader can get killed with a hostile scheme. So yeah, maybe we don't do that. So yeah, maybe we just keep him on content. This one actually increases opinion of legion vassals too. The only difference is the extra diplomacy, but yeah, we'll take first one. And this won't stress out our leader too. The other 2 options would have made her have another mental breakdown. Oh, and our lover actually became pregnant. And now we have some options. Do we want to keep the secret hidden? Or do we want to share the news? Our lover's secret will be exposed. All right, so I did a save and we lose a level of devotion for doing that. It's funny how we don't lose a level of devotion unless the secret is exposed, which I don't know exactly what that does. Being an adulterer does make everyone lose 5 opinion of us though. That's in our religion. So yeah, I don't know if I like that. We'll just make the secret stay hidden for now and we'll see what happens later on. So we split up our armies. We got 693 troops over here sieging another castle, and we got 1400 over here chasing these guys down. And yeah, these guys are weak now. We just beat them down too hard. They have 986 troops. They were were able to conjoin their armies, so they're going to put up somewhat of a fight here. And we do have a negative 2 battle advantage, I guess, for fighting this. But yeah, they... Well, I guess they had 500 bush hunters total. I don't think they had all 500 in this battle, though. Our champion killed one of them. Very nice. Kanawa Beat is a beast. The dude has 31 prowess. We ended up capturing this guy, who we can ransom for 50 gold, because I guess this guy's a vassal of this little kid. So yeah, we'll take that 50 gold for sure. After winning that battle, the war is far from over. We gotta keep attacking this guy. And actually, he's coming over here with his 674 troops. He was trying to go over here for our levies that we're sieging, but we're not gonna allow that. Oh, and here we go. Our lover now had the kid. And if we choose this first option, we learn of the kid's heritage, which he's a bastard. Or we could say, wait, the child is mine. And our lover's secret is exposed. Yeah, we don't want that. So we're gonna go for the first option. Now what happens with the kid? He's apparently our courtier, but he's not our son. And like, you can't inherit titles. So I don't know if there's really much of a point to that whole thing. I also found kind of an OP thing you can do with befriend schemes. So this guy actually has 20 prowess. We were able to befriend him. I think we can invite him to the court as well. Yeah, we can. So we get a knight with 20 prowess for doing that scheme. It was hard finding that guy, and I actually didn't even know you can do this. But if we find spouse with one of our kids, we can search by prowess. Even though it doesn't show up here as like a stat, it does rank these guys by prowess. Like Kanawa has 34 prowess now. I thought he only had 31. Where did he get his 34 from? This guy is getting kind of old though. He's 53 and he does have poor health. Apparently he is ailing, but legendary blade master does give him a huge boost to his health. So we're gonna hope that guy lives a lot longer. But yeah, like this guy has 22 prowess and he also does have the trait strong, which boosts his health, and he's got aspiring blade master, which does boost his health. So yeah, we're gonna befriend this guy too. That's another 22 prowess knight we're gonna get if this does work out, which I mean it will. There's no chance of it actually failing. Oh, and here we go. Our spouse hosted a tournament. We can either get 20 opinion of all of our champions, which I think is our knights for 10 years, or we get 150 prestige for free. We're going to take that prestige. We were getting kind of low on prestige. Meanwhile, with our war, this thing is taking forever. We're at 77% war score. We've captured 3 of their castles, which like I think we've captured everything we want to take, but this girl has 6 territories total. We are fighting another battle though. We started with 1250 against 300 and we just rolled over them. We captured this guy, Nanan Badu. This is their leader, I think. Yeah, we can ransom him for 50 gold. We're about to catch this guy's army too. He's got 571 troops up and we're quicker. Like he's trying to run, but he's not gonna be able to, I don't think. We got 100% war score. Like we're gonna fight him first though, I think. One free 25 prestige for this befriend event. Very nice. And yeah, let's see how this battle plays out. Our champion was maimed. Oh no. I think that was this guy, Nana Nimene. He's disfigured now, but that actually doesn't even matter much. This guy's our vassal, and the only negative for him is it lowers his fertility, but that's fine. We capture this dude who they will ransom for 10 gold. And what about this girl? This girl does have 20 in learning. They will not ransom her, but we'll just pick her up, and she can be a teacher for our kids. Not our son, but our 2 daughters need to be taught. Oh, and this girl would actually make a good high shaman. Apparently females can fill that role. So yeah, let's make her our shaman. For some reason, ours has not died yet. Dude's 73. He's done enough for us, though. It's time for him to retire. All right, so we're expanding our territory really well. We just took 3 new counties over here. We gave 2 of them away, and we're gonna hold on to Ite Bubu, as these guys did have a sparring grounds built in there. We're gonna now expand north a bit. We're gonna attack this guy who only owns 2 counties. He has no allies. Dude's super weak. He's gonna be pretty much a pushover. He's not gonna try to run, but our commander has more movement speed than him probably, so we should be able to run him down. Oh, and our son just picked up his 4th and final trait, and this one's actually solid humble, so I don't think we're gonna have to change it. Deceitful is not something we're looking for, so yeah, we're not gonna look at that one. And honest is okay, but I think humble's better. The extra 0.5 piety per month seems pretty good. So yeah, good job, beautiful, great leader Neo. We've raised you well, and your traits will be good for someone that's going to take over the kingdom one day. We're now going to keep expanding east. We got ourselves into a war against this dude who has 279 troops, but we got 1,000 coming in here from the north. We're going to have to cut them off with these 1,100. Meanwhile, we're sieging 2 castles at once. We're going to take both our holdings at once, so we're being uber efficient. Yeah, I would actually like to fight this guy. We will absolutely demolish him because he's got skirmishers, which we do destroy. We put a good amount of our archers in this group. We got 600. We just split up our army a bit, but we still got a good amount of archers here. We got 600 bush hunters, so yeah. We do have a negative 21 battle advantage here though, so the enemy's damage is increased, but their skirmishers are only dealing 20% of their normal damage. Oh, and our daughter became of age. She is a charismatic negotiator now. And apparently her betrothed is actually in prison. That's interesting. I wonder if we could break the betrothal here. For 75 prestige, actually, we could. So this guy's been our ally for quite some time, but he's been kind of getting stomped on, and he only has 2 territories left. And we don't really care about him being our ally anymore, so we broke that betrothal. We remarried our daughter to this guy, Bono, who is 54, but he does have the beautiful trait that increases his fertility by 30%. And he's lustful, so that increases it by another 25%. So ideally, before Bono dies, dies, we're gonna hope that he puts a few kids in our daughter, and then when he does die off, we can just remarry her. And wow, in these sieges over here, we ended up capturing 3 people. We ransom one for 25 gold, this guy for 50, and this girl we can ransom for 25. I don't even know if she has enough money to afford all of them. She actually almost did. We can get 21 gold for this last girl. Our great leader does have enough diplomacy to pick up another diplomacy perk, and this one's actually amazing. So friendly council makes it so each friend relation we have gives us 2 random skill points, and we got a lot of friends. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 friends. So this is going to be 18 skill points for our great leader. See here what we got. So 22 diplomacy, 6 martial, 4 stewardship, 6 intrigue, and 11 learning. And that boosted us by 4 diplomacy, 2 martial, 4 stewardship actually. So that's going to give us another domain limit, 3 intrigue, and 5 learning. Very nice. So we're up to 511 gold now, and there's actually stuff we can do with our gold. Now we can actually consume hashish cakes, and that will make us lose stress, but we go into a hashish stupor for 2 years, and we lose 1 stewardship and 2 learning for just 2 years. That's fine. Yeah, notify me when that becomes available and bring me a platter of hashish cakes. And we lose 24 stress off of that. So yeah, that's really good. We'll do that every 3 years. We want to get our stress level down to below 1, so we lose that negative 10% fertility, because we want to be pumping out as many kids as we can. There's also other things we can do, like we can seek aid of the spirits. I've actually never seen this before. It's actually free to do. Let's just do it and see what happens. So we got this event. Our shaman brings us to a peaceful glade near a small stream. The steady trickle of water over the rocks creates a relaxing ambiance. The spirits like it here, Monty. This is the best place for us to petition them for aid. Holding up 2 baskets Emba brought with her, she adds, now we must decide on what kind of offering we shall lead for them. So we can leave a grand offering, which will cost us 75 gold. Ooh, that's a lot. But the spirits will definitely take notice of it. We can leave a traditional offering, which will only cost us 15 gold, and the spirits are likely to take notice. Or maybe our presence should just be enough, and this will likely offend the spirits though. But the sheer audacity might impress them. Or on second thought, let us avoid disturbing them. I will say one thing about this third option is I'm thinking maybe this will lead to us getting possessed. And possessed is actually virtuous to our faith by a lot. It gives us 2 piety per month if we're possessed. So let's do this third option and let's piss off the spirits and hopefully they'll possess our leader. Emba stares at me perplexed. You offer yourself? I guess that works, she says as she starts walking around me in circles. Oh spirits, hear me. I call upon you to grant your aid to this petitioner, Emba chants. She begins moving faster, dancing now. Her movements become more frantic, sweat shining on her face. Eventually, she reaches a crescendo, barely finishing the dance before collapsing to the ground in exhaustion. With the conclusion of the ceremony, I feel different, altered somehow. We gain the tree spirit's blessing for 20 years. Wow. Plus 3 diplomacy. That's actually really good. And we get a medium boost to our health. Very nice. I mean, I would have liked to get possessed, but we can do this every 5 years. So maybe next time we'll get possessed. But yeah, what else can we do with our gold? So we can go on a pilgrimage. We can choose a destination among our face holy sites. The further we travel, the more piety we will gain. Longer journeys are more expensive. So yeah, let's prepare for the journey. We can just choose like this first option for 50 gold. And here we go. We're reflecting on our pilgrimage. This third option is just not good. We get almost 50 stress because we're zealous. This is all for the sake of appearances. We're basically saying like this is not a big deal, even though like we know this is a huge deal because we're zealous. We do get theatrical pilgrimage, and that increases theocratic ruler same faith opinion by 15. I don't really know if that does much. The second option makes us lose stress, which is nice, and we gain worldly pilgrimage for 10 years, increase our diplomacy by 2. Or the first option is pretty good. We get dedicated pilgrim for 10 years, 10% more monthly piety. I kind of like the losing stress thing though, and the diplomacy is nice too. So let's take the second option. Let's get our stress levels down. Oh, and we got 250 piety, by the way, off our pilgrimage. For 50 gold, that's a pretty good deal. Because our faith has ancestor worship, we get plus 10 opinion of our close family for 10 years, which isn't really a big deal, mainly just the piety. There's other decisions we can do, like we can call a hunt. Apparently this is really good, and we lose stress for doing this. I think we do it. Like, we don't really have anything to do with the gold, and we are no longer overwhelmed by stress. And good lord, we could potentially get killed here. There's a 9% chance we get killed if we do the first option. We could gain a hunting trophy for 10 years for 0.5 prestige a month. That's not worth it at all. 27% chance we get wounded, which wouldn't be too bad, but 9% chance we're killed. Yeah, no thank you. The second option makes us spend 150 prestige, and this guy gets a hook on us because I guess it'd be like a secret that he had to help us out. This third option though is available because of our diplomacy skill, and it allows us to become friend of animals for 20 years, and that increases our stress loss by 25% and our prestige by 0.2 a month. Yeah, we'll take that third option for sure. And we return home reinvigorated for 150 more prestige. The hunt is over. That was really worth it. One of these guys is actually going for our capital, and they're making good progress. They could get it, maybe. That would be terrible if they did.
Oh, it bumped up to 188, 189. Oh no, we could end up losing people if they take this. Come on, guys, get in there. It's at 185. No, please. 197. Oh, we barely saved it. We saved it though. And wait, here come more peasants. I hope they aren't able to continue the siege here. Like, if they can get in here and just siege for a second, they'll take our capital over. We could end up losing our heir. Like, our heir could get killed or imprisoned or something. All right, here we go. Battle against the stupid peasants that suck. They only have levies. And so, yeah. Okay, we did end up defeating them. And okay, phew. They had to engage us. They couldn't siege. And yeah, we have a 65 battle advantage, by the way. That increased our damage by 130%. These guys don't have a leader. They're recently disembarked. And yeah, we're not going to lose many units, I don't think. At the end there, we lost, like, was that like 30 or something? Oh, and here we go. Our heir became of age. He gained the trait skilled tactician and logistician. 3-star martial trait. That's not bad. I'm not complaining there. And this one increases our supply duration by 100%. So the reason why I had him focus on martial is because he turned out to be a rowdy. And it said that rowdy kids do well in either martial or intrigue. And I don't want him to be focused on intrigue. So yeah, we chose martial. And our heir is going to be martial focused. So yeah, that's what we have to look forward to when our leader does die. And also the kid's beautiful. We should find him a decent spouse. And maybe like this girl Jplo would be good. She's genius, so they could have babies with the beautiful trait and genius potentially. The only problem here though is we lose 300 prestige for doing it. After our leader dies and this kid takes over, we start with negative 300 prestige. It is worth it though, because the kids that they have will be our next heir, and if that heir has the genius trait, it's really worth it because that trait is insanely good. And on that positive note, we're gonna end the video. So here's Africa, and here's the territory we currently have. Being that we only do have around 1 day and 10 hours left, I don't know if this is gonna be possible. A very achievable goal though we could have is to create an empire in Africa, and this is actually a bit harder than normal, at least where we are, because to form the Empire of Guinea we need to take 77 counties. We currently only have 25, and we need another kingdom title. We currently only have one. When WoW Ascension drops, I'm gonna be mainly focused on that, but maybe I can get some more progress like every week or so for conquering Africa. Is that something you guys would like to see? If so, drop a like. And with that, I want to thank you all for watching. I will see you in the next one.